Hormonal imbalance. There are so many expressions of hormones that every female go through. And if there is an imbalance in the hormones, lot of things in life gets and seems to be very different. Which are those basic things that is known to everyone? Thyroid, hypo, hyper both, PCOD, irregular periods, heavy bleeding in periods, pregnancy hormonal imbalance, where a mother does go through few of the mood swings, irritation, fights, sleeping imbalance, and a lot of these things. Today we're going to learn about all those things that a girl can do to get her hormones right. In case any man is watching this particular video, please understand, it's a myth that only girls have got all these hormones. Guys have got their own set of hormones. If you can also do this particular set of exercises and pranayama, it's going to make you 150% a better and a far fit person. We're going to learn a combination of 5 exercises and 5 pranayamas. Let's learn. I will be talking at a specific point that for which particular thing this particular pranayama or exercise is very helpful. But overall, everything that we're learning today is going to help you for hormones. First exercise. Stand with both the legs joined, both the hands up, and just bend down and up, bend down and up, bend down and up. How many repetitions we should do? Ideally 10. This is one of the very good exercise which takes care of your PCOD problem, uterus related problem, genital issues. In case anybody has got diabetes, this has got an effect even to improve or to get your sugar levels dropped. So this will actually help you out. So once again, 4 and 5. Understand something. Exercise and pranayama need not be done only with the target of getting your hormones right. Hormonal imbalance is caused. One of the major reason is stress. Doing this 10 to 15 minutes of workout in the morning is going to help you as a stress buster also. So this will help a lot. So this first exercise. Second exercise which can actually help is sitting in a cat and camel position. This helps a lot to improve your blood circulation towards the lower area. At the same time, it's going to help a lot when it comes to thyroid. So it helps on few of the major areas where hormones are concerned. So just take the position. Please remember your wrist should be below your shoulder. You look up, back down. You look down and push your back up. Look up, back down. Look down and push your back up. Look up, back down. Look down and push your back up. Look up, back down. Look down, push your back up. This is going to help. This is one of the exercises that as it is helps you to get rid of your back pain. So helps a lot. Let's get into the next exercise. There's a third exercise. You sit in a Namaz position or Vajrasana. In case you've got a bigger belly or the bigger tummy, you need to take distance between your both knees. It's called as Balasana or a baby pose. Keep your hands at the back and just bend. How much time you're supposed to hold the position? Ideally 30 to 60 seconds, depending on your comfort level and how long you have been doing. But something very important thing that you have to understand that even this creates a lot of pressure on your abdomen, at your throat. So helps very well when it comes to hormonal imbalance. Next exercise, join both the legs. You turn and touch. So just see, you turn and touch. This exercise which helps to get twist on the internal organs which are located in the center area of your body. So because of this squeezing and twisting, it improves blood circulation to that area. At the same time, it's going to make them function better. Turn on other side. Twist. You can lift your hips up. See to it that both the legs are joined. So touch. Touch. And then touch. And then. So this exercise also helps to get your entire hormonal imbalance or your health back to normal. Sure, can we do this exercise in case I'm pregnant or I'm breastfeeding? Yes, 100% you can do these exercises, but with the range that is comfortable for you. Like in this exercise, I've seen pregnant ladies only bending this much. Only this much. So that's absolutely okay. Just take care of the range. All the exercises that we are showing are safe for pregnancy, breastfeeding, in your periods. You can do these exercises even in your periods. Four exercises have been already shown. I'm showing you last exercise. There's a fifth exercise. Lie down. Fold both the legs. And lift hips up. This creates pressure on your thyroid. So this actually helps you to improve blood circulation and helps the functioning of thyroid. Once again. And relax. Never get up straight, always turn and sit down. So these are the five exercises which will actually help you to get your hormones back to normal. Now about pranayama. Understand something very basic. There are seven chakras located in your body, three down, three up, and one at the center. So whenever you do any kind of a pranayama, understand the science behind it, how it works. Firstly, pranayama helps your oxygen consumption, your lung capacity, your blood circulation, your heart functioning. These all things are, I think, already known to each and every person around us. What we should know and what is different is that these all pranayamas helps you spiritually to feel centered, helps your chakras to release a lot of energy, and helps these internal organs to work better. Okay, so let's understand. First pranayama that works brilliantly well for thyroid is, you can sit in normal position, you can sit in namaz position, both the ways it's okay. Observe, you have to inhale, lips are closed, I have not exhaled. With one hand, close your both the nostrils, press your head down with other hand, and you have to gulp in your saliva. To gulp in, even if saliva is not there, the gulp in action is very important. So just observe, you inhale, with one hand close your nostrils, second hand press and gulp in your saliva. Up and release. You might feel your ears have been blocked, you might feel a slight pain at the chest, but don't worry at all. It's absolutely safe to do pranayama at any stage of your life. Works amazingly well on thyroid. Never change any medication because you're doing exercises or pranayama. Keep checking your reports, be regular on pranayamas and see the miracle happening in your life. So when it comes to this thyroid pranayama, ideally should be done 10 times at one go. So gulp in saliva how many times? At least 2 to 3 times with every breath. So this is one count. Inhale, I gulp in saliva 2 to 3 times and release. So this particular pranayama have got a direct impact on thyroid. So this will help. Second pranayama, it's Omkar. Omkar has got lot within it. It's not Om, it's A-O-M. A works on lower three chakras. So all the things which are related to lower part of your body, it'll work. O works on the center chakra of your body, which releases lot of positivity to you. Ma works on upper three chakras, so it helps you to gather a lot of energy from the surrounding and nature. So it should be said, just observe. Competition with anybody how long you can extend. It's just sitting peaceful, eyebrows relax, eyes softly close, and you do Omkar. Ideally it should be done 11 times. In case your culture does not allow you to do Omkar, you follow Islamic culture, all in Christian culture, you can do Ameen or Amen. I think every culture has got its own core beautiful chanting. which are going to help you to release energy from all the seven chakras. So this is the pranayama that actually helps to get your hormones back to normal. Third pranayama is Brigar or Bhramari. There are a lot of ways of doing it. There are few people who do it using all the fingertips. There are few people who do it just closing their ear flap. Anyhow you do it every day, it will give you results. Bhramari has got two types. Both the types we are going to learn. First type, just using tip of your finger, you close the flap of your ear. You inhale. You look down and you hum. You look up, again inhale, again sit down and humming. It's a plain humming. Because you're looking down, it creates pressure at the thyroid gland, so forces it to work better. Remember, all the exercises where I'm telling and all the pranayamas where I'm telling, it's helpful in thyroid or it's helpful in diabetes. Please remember, it works either ways. Even if it's hypo, even if it's hyper. So it helps in both the ways. The second way of doing Bhramari, ideally you should do both the ways, but it depends on how much you are involved at that moment. As I spoke about all the seven chakras, in yogic term they say that a sound releases energy from the chakras, but we don't know exactly which sound. Bhramari, you can do fluctuation. So you close the ear flap and you do up and down, so it goes like this. It might make you laugh when you do it for the first time, but trust me, it makes you feel super cool and super calm at your head. Very helpful pranayama, makes you feel super energetic whenever you do it. So that's the third pranayama, Bhramari. Fourth pranayama, which works very well on hormonal imbalance, is Nadi Shuddhi pranayama or Anulom Vilom pranayama, where you inhale from left, you exhale from right. You inhale from right, you exhale from right, left. Please remember, there should be no sound while inhaling or exhaling. There's no competition. You're not running for anything. Be as calm as you can. Your exhalation should be longer than your inhalation. So actually, once again observe. So inhale, exhale, inhale and exhale. It's one cycle. Do at least 11 cycles in the morning, 11 cycles in the evening. It's fabulous for hormones, fabulous for hormones. Last pranayama, there's a fifth pranayama. You sit in namas position or vajrasana. There's navel. So can you do this pranayama sitting in normal fold? Yes, you can if you can't sit in this. So basically you take your palms, thumb inside, both the fingers overlap and you place it in such a way around the navel. So my navel is at the center and I placed my both the fist across my navel. You inhale, you exhale at one go, tuck in your stomach and bend. Keep looking in front. There's a lot of pressure that you can feel at your stomach. Works amazingly well on diabetes and hormonal imbalance at the uterus. Inhale and release. This is one pranayama that you cannot do if you are pregnant. In periods, if you are having super heavy bleeding, you need to avoid these exercises on those 1 or 2 days. Once again, you take the position around your navel, inhale, exhale and bend. See in front. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See, for the sake of video, I have to count. When you're doing it for yourself, you can count it within your heart and mind. So doing this particular pranayama 10 times in the morning, 10 times in the evening will make sure that your sugar levels remain in control, your hormones remain in control. And all of you understand, a female is an expression of her own hormones. Her mood swings, her irritation, her weight, her periods, her pregnancy, everything is defined by her own hormones. If you can take care of these, they will take care of you. So remember to do all these exercises and all the pranayamas on a day-to-day basis. Thank you so much, all of you. Have a great time and bye.